Hey, this is Shweta, and in this video we will learn about comments, characters in C, operators in C, and some simple programs and some tricky one also. So here, what are the comments? Comments are usually we use to highlight something in a program. It is a good habit to use the comment in a program. Because after some day we'll open the program and look at it, then it will be helpful for us to understand the logic of the program, because comments are not the part of a C program. It is ignored by the compiler. Helpful to understand the logic of your code, because we can write the logic of any statement of a program inside the comment. And after some day when we will look at it, then it will be helpful for us to understand the program. Now we'll learn about the how many characters in the C program. All letters, digits, underscore, comma are called characters. There are 256 characters in C program. Capital A to capital Z, small a to small z, 0 to 9, and percentages. All these are the characters of C program and etc. There is another special character in C program, backslash n, which is known as a new line character. When it is used in printf, it causes the current output line to end and printing will start at the next line. Let us see in the C program the use of backslash n. Here we have written a program, and inside printf we have written welcome to backslash n, backslash n. So what is the meaning of backslash n? Backslash n is like any other character. It can be used multiple times even within the single message. We will use to here. What is the use? We can use it because it causes the current output line to end and printing will start at the next line. So we have used two backslash n. So first it will print welcome to, then first backslash n will move to the next line, and next backslash n will help us to move to the next line. So here our output will be this, welcome to CWorld. Next we will learn about the operators in C. Here this is the precedence table of the operators, and in precedence table we can see that parentheses has the highest priority in this precedence table of operators. So let us take example. Evaluate the expression int a is equal to 2, b is equal to 6, c is equal to 4, a less than equal to b logical, and b greater than equal to c. So from the priority table we can see that the relational operators has more precedence than logical operator. So a less than equal to b will be executed first, and b greater than equal to c will, as we can see that relational operators have associativity left to right. So first it will execute a less than equal to b, then it will execute b greater than equal to c. A less than equal to b means 2 less than equal to 6. Yeah, it's true. So output gives us 1. Then it will check b greater than equal to c. Yes, 6 greater than equal to 4. So it will give us output 1. And now it will perform the logical AND operation. 1 logical AND 1. It equals to 1. We know that when we are performing AND operation, if the expression 1 has the output 0, then the output of the whole AND operation will equals to 0. So there is no need to check the second expression. So this is the logic of the logical AND operation. Now we'll move to some tricky example. So here we have to check whether a given number lies between 1 and 10 or not. Here the given number is a is equal to 4. If we're solving this using mathematical expression, then we will write like this: while 1 less than a less than 10, printf ampersand D backslash N A is equal to A plus 1. So it will, first it will operate 1 less than A, because less than will have the associativity from left to right. So it will operate 1 less than A, which is always equal to 1, because 4 is always greater than 1 and 1 less than 10 is always true. So it will count to infinite loop. So we have to solve this using another method. First we have to take 1 less than A logical AND operation, then A less than 10. 1 less than A, yeah, it's true, it will give us 1, and A less than 10, 1 always less than 10, so it will also give us 1, and this operation will equals to 1. Now we will move why we need compilation. Computer cannot execute a C program or the individual statement of a C program directly. Compiler is also known as translator, because it translates from one language into another. It converts high level language, that is source code language, to machine level language, that is object code form. As our machine, our computer is not able to understand what you have written in C program, because it would always understand, it can only understand the binary form. So compiler will help us to translate it into the binary form. So this is done for today. Thank you.